the goddesses Sekhmet, Durga, and Kali all represent alchemical fire of transformation. They are the connection and communication between spirit and matter, and I'd like to talk to you about that today. Hi, I'm Molly Knight Ford, founder of the Awareness School. And in talking about personal power and people asking me questions about the struggle of transformation, I wanted to explain in light of these three goddesses, Sekhmet, Durga, and Kali, how they represent different aspects of our struggle, our intentional struggle to transform. They're definitely not pictures of peace and tranquility. They are often represented as dancing in the flames. I think you can see the bottom of that portrait of Durga right there. But each one of them, Kali and Durga, are both Hindu, and Sekhmet is Egyptian. They all have to do with ferocity and passion and surrender, and they're scary looking, and they are not the pretty side of us. They are the divine feminine in its power to cut through ego and to have courage in the face of fear, or to understand the enlightened power of emotion. So I have never been one to follow deities. I rely on source through my own self-knowledge and self-remembering, and through my own conscious choice in life. But I have had extremely personal experiences, especially with Sophia, the feminine Christ energy, in which she came to me in a holographic form at a time when I was very much struggling with my patterns with men and becoming free of them. And she came to me as a force of love, and I understood something about the emancipation of women and of my own freedom. And so as I talk to you today about these more fierce goddesses, it's really to explain how I experience their frequency, or how my real life experiences with transformation and struggle and darkness and surrender are often represented by their imagery. They are archetypes, they are psychological conduits, and they have a certain frequency. Sekhmet is an Egyptian goddess with a lion's head, and the Sanskrit root for Shakti, as well as the Egyptian root for Sekhmet, mean the sacred power of a realized human. And so she has come to represent for me courage in action. I may be fearful in some way, or having some self-doubt in something, and when I take action anyway, I experience this alchemical fire through struggle within myself of not wanting to do something, but actually really wanting to do it. And when I take action, I experience that struggle, or that yes and no within me. And she is the power of truth and being able to speak my mind and take action. She's also the Kundalini goddess, and that experience of the Kundalini energy, the rising serpent, may be a more advanced spiritual endeavor, but nevertheless, this representation of courage in action creates part of that fire that can bring on higher spiritual experiences. Now with Durga, she is always represented in flames, and for me represents that enlightened power of emotion. Now this is not about anger or justifying anger, or women as a collective justifying anger. To me, anger is another false emotion and state of identification, and I honestly am not saying that as a spiritual bypasser. What I am talking about with Durga is a passion and a knowing, a kind of emotional knowing that is beyond something like anger. And for me, this is my very maternal instinct and the power to have boundary around people and my own self, having the ability to speak my mind or stand up for others and myself. And this purity of emotion allows me to connect with God and with others in a way that I can't in ordinary, regular life. And then finally, Kali. She represents death and surrender. And she, you know, is a dark figure with wild hair, her tongue hanging out. And so this is a representation of me facing my own darkness and seeing my own self as Kali. And in those darkest moments when I must accept myself for who I am. And those are the very darkest parts, the self-pity, the hopelessness. And in that way, I can begin to see the false constructs that they are. And so for me, all of the skulls around her neck are representations of the death of those many false parts of myself. Just as with Durga, she has many arms with all of the weapons. And so she also represents a way of cutting through to the truth and using those kinds of weapons to break through egoism. And with Kali, back to Kali, the importance of death and experiencing a death within us that can bring about a true freedom is so important. And with that death is surrender to what is, and it can be a very, very dark place. And Kali also is representative of the times right now, all the darkness and the injustice and the disrespect for different groups of people that we see, and sort of the decline, the absolute decline of our civilization. She is representative in that way of this decline, and with the recognition of the force of Kali, we have the chance to realize what is needed and what can awaken and become birthed for the times ahead. So these three goddesses are wonderful examples for us all to work with transformation, to work with our own conscious labor and the way to intentionally suffer and stay within the yes and the no of ourselves to create a lasting freedom. Hope that helps this week. Get out there and struggle. See you next week.